For data transmission, we use single-mode fiber and multimode fiber. But why do we still use both types of fiber? If you want to find out more, stick around and we'll check it out. Before we answer that question, let's first have a closer look at the differences between single mode and multimode. Now, the most obvious difference is the core diameter, because for multimode OM1, we've got 62.5 micrometers, for OM2 up to OM5, we've got 50 micrometers, and for single mode, we've got that teeny tiny 9 micrometers core diameter. But the more important question is, why are these two called multimode and this one is called single mode? Or to be more precise, what is a mode? Now, the official description of modes is guided light propagation paths. And basically what that means is the number of paths that the light source or light signal will take through the fiber cable. And for single mode, hence the name single mode, it takes exactly one path. Whereas for multimode, it will take multiple paths through the fiber cable. And we're not talking about different signals. This is the exact same signal. It's not WDM with different wavelengths and different signals. No, it is that exact same signal. So, and we're also not talking about maybe two or three paths or modes. We're talking about multiple hundreds of paths that the light signal takes through the fiber. Now, why is that? Well, for multimode, we use more cost-effective light sources, so we're talking LEDs and VCSELs, and they actually emit a much broader signal, and in addition to the bigger core diameter, we then end up having these different modes. Now, the different modes actually come at a cost, and that cost is the so-called modal dispersion. And basically, what that means is, if we have a light pulse here that is entering the fiber cable, because it is taking the different paths, the length of paths that it takes, they actually vary. So in other words, if we go then through the fiber cable, you will see that it will start spreading, the pulse will actually broaden. And if we've then got multiple pulses after each other, they will at some point start bleeding into each other, meaning the receiver won't be able to distinguish between the different pulses. And that's also why multimode can only be used for shorter distances. So, in other words, single mode is the more superior technology. I mean, it can do short distances, but it can also do very long distances. We don't have all this modal dispersion topic with single mode. So now let's get to that original question. Why do we still use both single mode and multimode? Well, let's start off with the cost of fiber. Now, for multimode, a long time it has always been the case of that it was stated that multimode is more cost-effective than single mode because the manufacturing process is simpler. But no, that's not the case anymore because single mode is being manufactured in much larger volume, meaning that the cost difference between single mode and multimode is negligible. And also for multimode, we are using the more complex connectors, so we're talking MPO and MTP, whereas for single mode, we're using generally the LC connectors, which are much more cost effective. Also, let's talk about the number of fibers required. If we're looking at 100 gig and higher, so as an example, 100 gig, we're actually talking about 4 × 25 gig, once for transmit and once for receive. For single mode, we've got a built-in multiplexer in the transceivers, meaning that we still only need two fibers, one fiber for transmit and one for receive. But for multimode, we don't have that. In other words, for multimode, for that 100 gig signal, we actually need eight fiber cables or eight fiber cores to transmit the signal. So at the moment, it's not looking very good for multimode, but you need to look beyond the actual fiber cable itself to find out why multimode still has the justification. And starting off, we're talking about the cost of transceivers. Because we're using the more cost-effective light sources, the cost of multimode transceivers is lower and less than for the single mode. And the other very important part is the power consumption, because once again, the power consumption of the multimode transceivers is lower than that of the single mode transceivers. And if you take all of that together, then it still makes economical sense to use multimode for the shorter distances, and then from a technical point of view, obviously single mode for the much longer distances. So, I hope you learned something today and that you enjoyed this video. If so, please leave a comment. And of course, remember to follow our channel so you get your regular dose of brain snack. Until next time, bye-bye.